my name is Margaret Helton, and I've been with Women's Walk with Christ for about the past 12 years now. And this is a vlog called Speaking Life that Kim Turner and I have decided to do during these crazy times of pandemic. So welcome, and thank you so much for joining us.
And as she said, I'm Kim Turner, and we are both located here in Colorado. And I have been with Women's Walk with Christ since June of 2012. And we are excited to be doing this vlog together to be able to spend some time and some beautiful sisterhood time with each other, but also with all of you. And so Margaret is going to share her mission statement with us.
So as a woman, as a joyful woman walking with Christ, I co-create a world of peace and freedom through unconditional love, praise, and the constant desire to know and serve the Lord.
And I am Kim, and as a beautiful, self-confident, healing woman walking with Christ, I create a world of pure joy and self-acceptance by helping others to see their beauty as they gaze within, by sharing my gifts of unconditional love, laughter, and a tender mothering heart.
Beautiful.
Thank you. So we have our first guest this week. And so Margaret's going to give us a little introduction of who we have waiting in our green room.
Dun, da, da, da. Today we will be talking to the one and only Debi Spicer. Debi Spicer is the director of our ministry. Some of you may know her as she might have been a co-leader on your weekend. She is one of the founding members of Women's Walk with Christ. She and several other women helped write the protocol that we still use today. And she'll talk a little bit more about that, about her experience and of the very first weekend. She was on the very first weekend, and we're just really excited for you to get to know her a little bit better and to talk to her and to hear more about her experience over the many years that she's been in Women's Walk with Christ.
Okay, so let me admit Debi right now. Hang on just a second.
Hey!
That's Debi Spicer! Hello!
So good to see you. Thank you for joining us.
Hey, I'm excited to be here with both of you.
We're excited for you to be our first guest. You're like a guinea pig.
Thanks. That's a real honor.
So we mentioned and we gave a little brief introduction of who you are and what position you are with Women's Walk with Christ. And so is there anything you would like to share a little bit about yourself as well?
Okay, I don't know what you said, but I'm sure. I think for me, the biggest thing that I always want women to know about me and Women's Walk is that I have felt called from the very beginning by Jesus to stand in this ministry and help create this ministry. But also I go to prayer every year about, is it my time to continue to stay, or does he want me to go? So I'm really prayerful about the role that I have in Women's Walk. And I'm very blessed to stand as the director of Women's Walk.
We're very blessed to have you.
Thanks.
How long have you been with Women's Walk, Debi?
Well, since the very beginning, 2004. A group of women got together after nudging from my husband and my husband, Steve Spicer, one of the founders of Mark Men, and Father John Lager, the other co-founder of Mark Men for Christ. And they asked a bunch of women to get together and see if this was something that we wanted to do, because the men were asking, is there anything for the women? And at that time, of course, I thought my life was really full. And, you know, this, I didn't know if there was a place for anymore. And after prayer and time together, we got together and started writing a protocol. And it took us a year and a half to get that protocol written. We felt very led by the Holy Spirit, and knowing where he was taking us was such a gift in all of that. And then 16 years later, here we are.
Wow. That's amazing.
So I wonder if you can share with us a little bit about what the first weekend was like, the very first Women's Walk with Christ weekend.
Oh, wow. I think back to that very first weekend sometimes, because one, we didn't really know. We had a process and a protocol written. We took our protocol, the five wounds, and some of the process out of Mark Men for Christ. They shared their protocol with us. But it was much more intense. It was much more, more manly, more than women can take. And so we stood in a really harsh place, which thank God that he led us to be able to know that that wasn't the right direction for the ministry. We actually had those women that attended the first weekend stay with us afterwards, like a focus group. And we went through a bunch of questions and asked them many, many questions. And that led us to some of the changes that we made. But mostly over the years, it really is the Holy Spirit speaking through me or others on the board to come and say, this is where I feel like we should be going. And maybe we'll do this process or we'll change. But most has stayed the same, although our feeling in it all is that we come from a much more tenderhearted place.
Good.
And I can say, I'm glad we are.
Me too. Me too. Yes.
So let's have you start by sharing your mission statement with us.
As a beloved woman walking with Christ, I co-create a peaceful, loving world by embracing every day with joy, faithfulness, and courage while sharing my gifts with others.
Beautiful. And how long did it take you to write your mission statement?
Oh, that was something. We knew that we wanted mission to our Lord Jesus Christ to be part of the weekend. And in the beginning, we all went through kind of a prayerful process to decide that, but also what was our mission. We had some guidelines from Mark Men, like I said before, but it took some time. And I think overall, it took me about 3 months to get to a place where I knew that the words were right. I knew that this is where the Lord was calling me. And basically, my mission statement has stayed the same over the years. There might be a word that changes here or there based upon what's happening in my life, but pretty much has stayed the same.
Thank you.
That's really good. Yeah. I can say the same thing about mine. Mine has pretty much stayed the same over the past 13 years, but just little words here and there. Either I added a word or I just changed one word. So that's interesting.
Yeah.
So how has God changed your life through Women's Walk with Christ?
I have a hard time remembering what my life was like before Women's Walk. Of course, God knew what I needed the most, and that was mission. I needed focus. And I also needed women. I needed sisters in my life. And I know the change in me is more about intentionality. So I wake up today and I'm more intentional about my day. And I know that I want to live in mission to Jesus today. And then I also know that I can't live my life now without the support and love of my sisters, including both of you, for sure. I just know that the focus that I have today is
we're giving you our heart symbols.
Thanks. The focus I have today is because I'm able to wake up every day and know that Jesus is with me throughout the day, and I'm doing my best to the best of my ability to live in mission to him.
And so I would gather that you are in a spirit circle.
Yes.
And has your spirit circle been the same, or has that changed over the years too for you?
You know that it has changed quite a bit, actually. In the beginning, you know, we were a tight group, so we had very few circles. It was more like north or south, kind of Denver kind of thing. And now, of course, we're all over the country and in Europe as well. But my personal spirit circle, I've been with these women for quite a long time now. And I look forward to going to circle. I know that circle is for me, and I know that circle is for me to be there for others as well. And it gives me, again, focus, and it allows me to go to circle and do work on myself. I know that I'll be working on myself to the day I die. So hopefully I'll be able to go to circle for a long, long time, but also to be there in support of others in their work and to be prayerful during that time too.
Yeah. So out of all of our agreements that we have, what do you think your favorite Women's Walk with Christ agreement is?
Oh, gosh. My favorite, besides sisterhood, because I think that's the easy answer, is sisterhood. my favorite is intentionality. So much like I was focused on being intentional about my mission, being intentional about myself, interacting with the world. If the world would just agree to our agreements, we would have such a beautiful place to live in.
That is true.
I know it. I just know it. But to seek to know the will of God in my life and to live life with focus and a mission. That's what the intentionality agreement really is. And I hope that I do that to the best of my ability every day.
Good. Sounds like Kim has a friend with her in the background.
They're quiet all day until you want to do something.
Of course.
Today at some point, have somebody sneak out of his back door. So I'm just it's my dad.
Welcome. In. We welcome all furry creatures.
Sure.
I'm coming to you being honest.
That's good.
So our last question for you, Debi, which is one that Margaret and I are excited to ask everybody, is what is the most impactful thing that a wise woman has told you?
You know, I had to really think about that because I've had so many beautiful things said to me over the years by so many women. But I know that early on, and even still, I really wrestle with worthiness. So why would God pull me as an interior designer out of the world to step into this work and step into this leadership? And so, gosh, over the years, two women in particular, and they know who they are, have been those pillars to stand behind me with their hands up, you know, pushing me up at times. And I just truly remember one time being with the two of them, and they said to me, and of course, I don't know if you don't know, you two probably know, but the rest don't, but I'm talking about Susie Schnorbusch and Lucy Walsh, beautiful, mm-hmm. wise women in the ministry. They have said to me over and over that you are chosen and you are anointed and God called yeah. you into this place. And I just have such beautiful memories of walking with them and still walking with them today. I love both of them dearly, for sure.
And I think, were they also two of the founding members that helped?
Yes, they were. Both of them were as well. Yes.
They are. They are very wise and beautiful women.
For sure.
Yeah. Well, that's really great. I'm so glad that you've had them for so many years, and we've both been blessed by them as well. So we're grateful that they're in our ministry, but that they encouraged you for so many years, and you've been through so much with the ministry, and you've been such a blessing, and you've taken us to places that I never believed that we would go, and you led the charge, and so we just honor you and love you for that. So I'm glad that you had their encouragement.
Thank you. I just try to listen to what Jesus has to say and do my best to follow his will, for sure.
I think yeah. what all of us are trying to do, it's just there's so much noise sometimes, especially now, to shut that out and to be able to hear what he says. So it's important, I think, that we stay connected, especially with our sisters, to help us to quiet ourselves to be able to hear what he's saying to us. So
very wise, Kim, very wise.
Things are working up there.
I realize that the more I go to work, and like you say, if everybody agreed to our agreements, man, my life would be so great. But it's hard. And so I need my sisters to ground me back in that. And it's a necessity in my life, you know, and it's hard for me when I can't see them and be in person. So this is
pretty yes. fine,
but we're trying something new. So hopefully this helps us connected a little bit better.
It always kind of takes me aback when I talk to someone and I say, oh, Debi Spicer. And they're like, who? And I'm like, you don't know Debi Spicer? But I guess if people didn't go on there, if you didn't co-lead their weekend, then they wouldn't know you. And so I'm grateful that they people will have the opportunity to get to know you a little bit better through this interview and talking to us today.
Yeah, that's nice. I've also had the opposite of that, where I'll meet a woman for the first time and I'll say, hey, my name's Debi Spicer. And they go, oh, you're the one we get all the emails from.
Like,
I hope it's more than that for sure.
So it can be Debi Spicer in the right hand and Debi Spicer in the left hand.
Definitely.
Which one are you? Are you a right hand Debi or a left hand Debi? Well, in continuing with the thread of getting to know you better, we have developed a section of the show that we're calling the fuzz.
Okay.
Kim, would you like to explain what means?
We were just trying to think of a way to kind of end our interviews with people. So the fuzz stand for Funny Fuel for Fridays.
Okay. Okay.
We would like for you to share something that's your one of your favorites. Like, what is your favorite movie you've ever seen?
Okay. I think my favorite movie is The Notebook, honestly. It's such a sappy love story. And oh gosh. And at the end, you know, he's holding her, and it always brings me to tears for sure. So that is definitely my favorite movie.
That's a good one.
Really?
Yeah. What, this is kind of a multi-part question. So what is your favorite meal of the day, breakfast, lunch, or dinner? Is it homemade or takeout? And what is it?
It's homemade, isn't it, Debi?
Oh, that's funny. Well, that's a good thing to know about me, is that I don't really like to cook. So I am not the best cook. My husband cooks most of our meals here. But I think my favorite food is Mexican food. Both of my parents were born in Brownsville, Texas, and that's where I was born as well. And so I feel like that's kind of my heritage, is that I have this, you know, heritage. I'm not Hispanic, but I feel like that's part of my soul for sure, because I love Mexican food. So I could have it every day.
So I'm going to insert a funny story about your cooking skills or lack thereof.
Okay.
I was at your house one time and I turned on the oven and I was preheating the oven to cook something, and I started to smell something, and your son Scott was like, no, there's stuff in the oven. My mom stores stuff in the oven. Take it out. And there was like chips or something in the oven, and we had to take it out so that they wouldn't catch on fire. And I never met anyone that stored things in their oven. So that was a first for me.
That's very real, Margaret. That's very real. Oh, a little embarrassing, but true.
But hey, if you need the extra storage, it's a good place for it.
Right? Funny.
That's a good pa-pa-pa-pa. And so we both wanted to say, we know that there's somebody that you might want to share with us that has joined your family recently.
Aw, thanks. Recently, over in July 24th, I became a Mimi, a grandma, and such a joy for my life. And I was just texting with my son. He was texting me pictures of my grandson, Cade. And I get so teary and emotional and, you know, laughing and all kinds of things around my little grandson that I knew I had in me, of course, but that's not generally my outlook or the way I am. But I'm telling you, when I get around this little boy, I'm a gushy little grandma.
And what is his name again?
His name is Cade.
Oh.
Cade Zachary Spicer.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, congratulations. It's fun to see your joy. It's contagious whenever I see you hold.
Thanks. Yes, it's such a gift. I didn't know if that was going to be part of my life, and I am just thrilled and overjoyed that God has sent this little boy into my life.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Well, we thank you for joining us here today. And thank you for your time, and we really appreciate you.
Ah, thanks. And I just want to send out many blessings to all the women in Women's Walk. It's a gift for me to lead this ministry. And one of the questions you guys sent was, what would be your dream job? Well, I have my dream job. My dream job is to lead a Christian women's ministry. and to be able to love and support each other in this ministry is such a gift to me, for sure.
Thank you.
We are all blessed and thankful that you listened and started this ministry
for us. Ah, thank you, Kim. Yes. Well, thanks to both of you for this new video blog that you call it. And I have great hopes for the two of you leading this and getting to know other women this way as well.
Thank you.
Thanks for being our first guest.
Bless you both.
Bye.
Bye.
Bless you. Bye. That was really fun. I'm really glad she was our first guest and that we were able to do that. I think one of the things that she said that was most impactful for me was about the agreements. And we kind of mentioned it about, you know, just that if everybody was able to live by the agreements that we live by about honesty and integrity and intentionality and sisterhood and, you know, we're not always trying to fix each other or we're just being loving, you know, and I think about that every time I hear it in the spirit circle protocol, you know, that we live by these agreements, not just when we're sitting in spirit circle, but when we're in our day-to-day lives, no matter where we are, we're agreeing to those agreements. And I think if more of us, you know, as if we continue to do it in the world, you know, maybe even if people don't really understand or know the agreements or have been through a weekend, then maybe that they'll see the peacefulness that we have in our lives and the, you know, the sisterhood and the connections that we have with other women, and it'll kind of rub off on the rest of the world. But I think that was one of the things that she said that was most impactful to me.
And I think we always say that it's not that we live 100% to those agreements every day, but we all strive to do that.
Sure.
As long as you're constantly striving to do better, that's what he expects of us. And so these just give us those little guidelines that we can lean on every now and then. And, you know, some days I need to lean on the authenticity one, or sometimes I need to lean more on the integrity. And so I love it that it just gives me something to look to say, okay, what are you going to do today? How can you be better today? Let's pick one of these. And so I just love that. And I love their purpose. So I'm really thankful for those two. And I like that we ask that question of people. I think that's a good
question. Yeah. Do you have any other thoughts on anything else she shared?
Like I said, I was excited to hear about the women's or the wise woman, because I too have had so many wonderful things. But when we were talking about the questions, I was like, oh, that's always my favorite part of the weekends, even is the wise woman journey. I just love to be able to see the new sisters going and meeting these women that have been in Women's Walk for a long time. And I've been blessed to have been a wise woman a couple of times. And it is so beautiful to be able to have that one-on-one connection with people. And I know how close Debi is with Susie and Lucy. So I always love to hear their connection and just different ways that they've supported each other and sisters through the years. And I just love that part. I love the wise woman part. And like I said, that's one of my favorite parts on the weekend. So,
yeah. Well, that was fun. I'm glad we got to talk to her. That was really great.
It was beautiful.
So we will continue with our fuzz.
You'll all be saying it. Don't kid yourself. You're just going to walk around and go, my
It's going to get in your head.
What do they call those things? Like an earworm or something?
Once yeah. You
do something, it's going to happen. So here's our... We decided we were going to, in our section, we were going to share a Bible verse, and I'm going to read it in one version, and then Margaret's going to look at it in another version, just so that you can see the different ways that it can be read and or interpreted also as well. But it's the same verse with kind of the same message. So I'm going to read Psalms 34, verses 17 through 19, and in my Bible, I have the Good News Bible, and it's the English version. So it says, the righteous call to the Lord and he listens. He rescues them from their troubles. The Lord is near to those who are discouraged. He saves those who have lost all hope. The good man suffers many troubles, but the Lord saves him from them all.
That's good. Yeah. So my version, I looked it up in the Message version just to see like what it said. And the Message version is always I think it's a little bit like more real world. Like it's, the language is sometimes easier to understand, but that's one of my favorite spiritual practices, is to kind of compare verses into different versions and see how different words were interpreted and stuff. And, in the Message version, this, Psalms 34, 17 through 19 says, "Is anyone crying for help? God is listening, ready to rescue you. If your heart is broken, you'll find God right there. If you're kicked in the gut, he'll help you catch your breath. Disciples so often get into trouble. Still, God is there every time."
Wow. That's beautiful.
Isn't it interesting that it's the same verse, just interpreted a little bit differently, but it's the same word, same message.
That's beautiful. I love that. And I think, to me right now, that really spoke to me just with all that's going on right now. You know, I think there's a lot of people that are crying out and he is listening, and we just have to be more diligent about that and trusting his process and what's going on in the world. But I find that interesting that yours is so different, but I love that message. It is the same, but still just very different.
I love that. Different style. It would be like a Toby Mac style. That's what I think of whenever I read the Message. Like, this is how Toby would say it.
It's got a little Cajun flair.
It's a spicy pot of gumbo. That's what he always says.
I love that. So look it up in your version of your Bible that you have and see how it's different from the one that we have. And I'll tell you how I came to find that verse today is, I don't know if a lot of you know who Tara Gilly is from Women's Walk, but she always has these amazing little verses that she prints out on the weekends, and she has blessed me with a lot of these. And this is the version that I found in my office that she had left for me, which is also totally different from both that Margaret and I read. So I would be interested to just kind of hear maybe if you have some feedback about how you read that message and what that means to you. So if you have any comments about that that you'd want to share with Margaret and I, please feel free to shoot one of us an email.
Absolutely.
Thanks.
So there's another segment of our show that we'd like to introduce as we close out. Kim, please share with us your additional encouragement.
So today I was thinking about this, and I get some really crazy ideas in the shower. I don't know why. It's like my only quiet space. So today it came to me that we, as women walking with Christ, we need to be aware and be diligent about the A, B, C, D, E, Fs of the world. And because Christ died, everyone is free. Not just me, everyone. Everyone is free because he died for us. So my thought for you guys these next couple weeks, as you're going through your day-to-day life, look for those A, B, C, D, E, Fs of your life. If you see somebody that maybe isn't quite in the same space you're in, maybe they need that encouragement from you because they've been free too. And maybe you can share your story with them of your walk with Christ, or how you've had a healing over this period of time, this pandemic time. How has God shown his light to you? Because he died for us, we get that freedom, and we get so many freedoms in this life from him because of that. And so look for those in your day-to-day life, the little nuggets, the little ABCs that are out there. And they'll feel you, I promise, if you can just find them. And I know that sometimes that's hard, especially with all the noise that's going on. But there really are some beautiful things that are going on in this world. And I think that's kind of how we're going to end our show every week, is to try to find something good that has happened, especially within our own Women's Walk community. I think if you have a Holy Spirit goosebump story that you want to share with Margaret and I as well, that you would be okay with us sharing on this public feed, we would love to share that, because everybody needs something positive to focus on instead of all this negative. And that's really what Margaret and I want to try to do for all of you, is to speak just a little bit of life into each one of you as you do this into each one of us.
Yeah. Tell us again what the ABCD is.
ABCDEF is, "And because Christ died, everyone is free."
Mm-hmm. You're so smart. That's so much knowledge up there. I just love it.
Just get stimulated in the shower.
You should take more showers. All kinds of good ideas come out of you in the shower.
We all pruny, but that's okay.
Cool.
And us, Margaret.
Yes. So we just want to thank you for taking the time to watch this and to share a little bit of time with us and being sisterhood with us. If you're watching this on Facebook or on YouTube, definitely leave us a comment or a thumbs up and let us know that you're here. And if you have any ideas, we said this in the first episode, but if you have any ideas of what you'd like us to ask the guest, if you would like to be a guest on the show, then shoot us an email. My email is margaret@womenswalkwithchrist.org. And Kim's is kim@womenswalkwithchrist.org. And we'd love to hear from you and hear how this is impacting your life. And we hope that it's impacting your life in a positive way, in a good way, and that you got a little bit of break from this crazy world that's going on right now and got a little bit of peace and maybe laughed a little. That's the goal. So we just thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Bless you.
Bless you.